find people, mashallah, coming to deen, starting to practice deen, their ibadah change, they leave sin, but the ability of changing their akhlaq, their manners, they still can't. We find them still joking in a foul way, in a coarse way, using bad language. We find them still, for example, harming others with the tongue, lying, saying things that they shouldn't be saying, arguing, debating, a very, very bad quality that comes, especially people that come to deen, mashallah. He, yesterday he wasn't praying, today he comes to deen and starts and builds this habit of arguing with others, debating and arguing for no valid reason, for no valid target. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in the hadith, أَنَا زَعِيمٌ. Look at the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقًّا. I guarantee, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is guaranteeing, I guarantee a house in Jannah, in paradise, for the person who leaves an argument, leaves the debate that has no use, even if he is on the haq, even if he has the right, even if he is on the right, still leave these arguments that reach nowhere and lead nowhere. Leave these bad arguments that brings heart problems between Muslims, brings controversy between the Muslims. Leave the debates, even if you are on the haq. Accept a proper debate, a scholarly debate, a well-mannered debate that actually targets finding the truth and everyone is humble and sincere. So Rasulullah is saying, أَنَا زَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْمِرَاءَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مُحِقًّا وَبِبَيْتٍ فِي وَسَطِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْكَذِبَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مَازِحًا. And I promise, I guarantee a house in the middle of Jannah for the person, for the believer who leaves lying, even if as a joke. Look at the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَزَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي رَبَضٍ فِي وَسَطِ الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ تَرَكَ الْكَذِبَ وَإِنْ كَانَ مَازِحًا. A person that would leave lying, even as a joke. How many times a day do we find ourselves indulging in a lie? Like, oh brother, it's just a joke. I was just joking with you. Look at the words of Rasulullah. I guarantee you a house in the middle of Jannah. That person who leaves lying, even though if as a joke. وَزَعِيمٌ بِبَيْتٍ فِي أَعْلَى الْجَنَّةِ لِمَنْ حَسُنَ خُلُقُهُ. And I guarantee, and I promise a house in the highest part of Jannah for that person who builds and develops good manners. He has good manners, he has good conduct. For this person, I guarantee him a house in the highest portion of Jannah, the highest part of Jannah. Allahu Akbar. These are the promises of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Once Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was also asked, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سُئِلَ عَنْ أَكْثَرْ مَا يُدْخِلِ النَّاسِ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, a person came to Rasulullah and asked him, Ya Rasulullah, what's the most thing that will take people to Jannah? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam answered, تَقْوَى اللَّهِ وَحُسْنُ الْخُلُقِ. تَقْوَى اللَّهِ, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Person has fear of Allah, and حسن الخلق, having good conduct, good manners. These are the two things, the most things that make people enter paradise. وَسُئِلَ عَنْ أَكْثَرْ مَا يُدْخِلِ النَّاسِ النَّارِ. And he was asked about the things that take people most to hellfire. فَقَالَ صَلَى اللَّهِ سَلَمَ الْفَمْ وَالْفَرْجِ. The mouth, alright? Meaning the tongue. What the tongue says, how he harms others, how he breaks the hearts of people, oppresses others. الْفَمْ وَالْفَرْجِ. And your private parts. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in another hadith, مَنْ يَضْمَنْ لِي مَا بَيْنَ لَحْيَيْهِ وَمَا بَيْنَ رِجْلَيْهِ أَضْمَنْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever can guarantee me whatever is between his jawbones, meaning the tongue, he will control the tongue, keep the tongue on the right path, not harm others, have good conduct, have good manners. مَنْ يَضْمَنْ لِي مَا بَيْنَ لَحْيَيْهِ وَمَا بَيْنَ رِجْلَيْهِ. And whatever is between his legs, meaning his private parts, أَضْمَنْ لَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. I guarantee him paradise. These are the words of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.